the ambitious man about town, there's no better accessory than a well-tailored suit. But having one custom-made can cost a whole lot of time and a whole load of money. Unless you go to the legendary Express Tailors of downtown Bangkok. So, how do they do it? Bangkok, Thailand. On almost every street, you'll find a tailor's shop. But for those in the know, there's only one place to go. From celebrities like Bob Hope to politicians like Senator John Kerry, they all come to Raja's Fashions. Raja Galati and his son Bobby have been fitting out the famous for over 45 years.
A suit makes a heaven of a difference, I would say. The first thing when you see someone for the first time, whether it's a job interview or a meeting, the first thing is your presentation, is how you look.
After a long trip around Asia, Nick here is about to fly back to London for a career-making interview.
Welcome, sir. How are you?
I'm Bob. He needs a suit that will seal the deal.
Okay, come on in, please. Cheers. What are we looking for?
The problem is, his flight takes off in just 72 hours. For clients with no time to spare, Bobby and Raja have to have an array of 400 different fabrics ready and waiting. Because the manufacture of these high-quality threads won't happen in a hurry. The cloth comes from 10,000 kilometres away in West Yorkshire, England. Here at Taylor & Lodge in Huddersfield, they turn plain woolen threads into usable fabric. To weave a high-quality suit fabric, you start by lining up 6,000 individual threads, attaching them to metal wires on this Delta machine. On the loom, the wires lift and drop the threads, creating a gap. At speeds almost too fast to see, fingers of metal called rapiers zip through the gap, carrying another thread. The threads interlace, creating a tight weave. And the final fine fabric is then dispatched to bespoke tailors all over the world. With all the time-consuming work done in advance, customers in a hurry like Nick can just pick a fabric off the shelf, and Bobby can go to work.
Let's measure you up.
The first step in making a made-to-measure suit is the measuring.
Very well built, huh?
Thank you for saying so, Bobby.
But Nick's remarkable build is posing a challenge.
Very long arm.
The tricky bit is cutting the 2D cloth to fit Nick's three-dimensional body. Most people would need to follow a cumbersome paper-cutting pattern. But all master tailor Uttaman Sinatung, better known as Tool, needs is the measurements, a ruler, and a piece of chalk. The shapes he cuts will fold together to make sleeves, trouser legs, pockets, and the main body of the suit. Just 30 minutes after Tun started chalking, the sections are ready for stitching together. But Raja's stitching workshop is way on the other side of town, and some of the worst traffic in the world is in the way. The solution is a scooter. Arriving at the workshop, our intrepid rider passes the fabric panels on to a team of the fastest seamsters in the East. Racing against time, the sections are stitched together. The lining is added and pads inserted. 4 meters of fabric, several hundred stitches. A mere 4 hours after Nick walked through the shop door, the basic shape of the jacket and trousers has been stitched together. But all the hems are left loose to allow for adjustments. Early the next morning, 48 hours before takeoff, and Nick's back for his first fitting. Every body has its peculiarities.
People don't realize that they have one hip lower, or one leg longer than the other, or one shoulder lower than the other. So it's our duty to look at that and make sure that the nips and tucks are done to make it right.
The hems and seams between sections are adjusted for the fit and repinned into place.
We started the jacket a little bit long. I think it could be taken up a little bit.
Sure.
The sleeves are added and the suit is whisked back across town to replace the tailor's pins with pinpoint precision stitching. Just 3 days after walking into the store, Nick's wearing the finished article.
looks like it was made for you, sir. Mm-hmm.
And he's in plenty of time for the flight. Back in London, it's the day of the big interview, and Nick's looking sharp. Pity the shoes he brought back from his travels didn't go down as well as the suit.